Very enlightening, isn't it? Well, somebody keeps stealing. That's right, thefts on 666. And you know what? They're stealing the signs because of the metal, I would assume. And this particular article deals with what's going on in New Jersey, but it's nationwide, Jack. 666 is disappearing, those signs.
And in Pennsylvania. Now, they ask why. It said maybe it's college students playing a prank. Maybe it's satanic groups wanting this sign because the Bible ties it in with Satan in the final days. But I'm telling you, folks, this economic failure is coming again in the future. It's only a band-aid we're going to put on it now, because after the rapture, after we're gone, the economy collapses and they go to a new numerical system based on 666. Revelation 13, verses 16 to 18. Oh, we're the generation.
Oh, Jack, how what a blessed hope. Well, let me just say, friends, we have a brand new offer, and it is flying out of here. Take a look at what it's about. Christ returns this generation.
500 prophecies presently fulfilled prove that Christ's return could become reality at any moment. 21 church fathers for the first 430 years of the faith taught that Christ would arrive at the start of the 21st century. Pagan prognosticators, including the Mayans, Incas, and Hopis, also looked to the 21st century, December 21st, 2012, for the final day of history, the end of the world. The Banabees proved these pagan forecasters wrong in a startling new video, Christ's Return. This generation? Instead, they proclaim what could become the greatest event in history, the appearing of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. First, seven major global events had to happen. They have since 1948. Order the video, Christ's Return. This generation? See why.
Oh, let me just say, friends, that I did not honestly believe it could be in my lifetime. Jack talks about the return of the Lord all the time, but Jack, you prove on here it could be this generation.
And some of these lackadaisical Laodicean Christians say, oh, it'll never happen in my lifetime. Wait a minute. Jesus said in Matthew 24:33, you will know when it's near, even at the door. In fact, the Greek imperative is there. I command you to know when it's near, even at the door. And if Jesus said the generation that lives to see these signs shall not pass, if they know, you think he didn't know? Oh, it's also near.
There's your 800 number, and there's the address. Please do not put it off. You want to have this in your home, so make the call right away, and we'll get it in the mail as soon as we hear from you. Christ's return. This generation will give you the answer for sure right on here. All right? Well, you know, friends, someone who looked ahead in 1999 was Dr. Jack Van Impe, and you're going to be amazed at what he had to say, because it's all about the economy. The new economic order is coming. The apparatus is nearly in place for central planning on a global scale. However, as with most radical plans, it will surely be preceded by a crisis of enormous proportions. In all probability, he went on to say, a worldwide recession. Watch for it. Read the business section of your morning paper with the discernment that comes with new eyes, because the signs of global economic chaos are on the horizon. Now, we're going to see exactly what he had to say happening. Whew! I can't imagine that he came up with that. Well, take a look at the cover of Fortune magazine. Paulson to the rescue. It seemed like our financial system was collapsing. So the president presented something to Congress, and Paulson told us all about it. Let's go on to this next headline. The failure of the $700 billion bailout was a disaster, because Wall Street went tumbling and we had $1.2 trillion of disaster there. So the Senate said, all right, if Congress won't pass it, we'll come up with a bailout. Senate moves to rescue the bailout. Well, did they do it? We'll take a look at this next headline. Senate passes bailout bill. Well, they say that there are some things that we want actually described that would be a little bit different, but they did pass it. And now, friends, I could not help but take a look at this next headline that really moved my heart. America first or politics first? With everything happening like that, there was a lot of anxiety in America. And I can't help but wonder what went on in Washington. They needed to get together for sure, didn't they, Jack?
Oh, they did, Rexella. And let me tell you, whatever they're doing now will only be a temporary Band-Aid. During the tribulation hour, after the rapture, it's going to completely come apart. And you know, I've used these verses many times in 1999, and I used them 2 weeks ago, but I want to again go to Revelation chapter 18. This is the tribulation hour. The rapture has occurred. It's about the 42nd month during the tribulation hour, and the merchants are wailing and weeping. Read the chapter. Verse 10 says, "For in 1 hour is thy judgment come." Verse 17, "For 1 hour so great riches has come to naught." Verse 19, "In 1 hour she made desolate." I used to wonder how this could all happen in an hour, overnight. Now we do know. And it's going to happen, as I said. After 42 months of the tribulation period, in the day of the wrath of the Lord, Revelation 16, 1. And it's then, because everything globally has failed, they go to a new numerical system, 666. I'm going to say a lot about that next week.
You know, Jack, something happened just recently, of course, when the United Nations had their last session. They have even said, we will never, never have another Holocaust. We will prevent another Holocaust. All right, we all know who is responsible for the first one, Adolf Hitler, and there he is. Somebody else we could call a bully for sure. Ahmadinejad blasts the U.S. at NATO bullying. And this is why they said this about him. The American empire is near its end. Can you imagine the arrogance he had? And then Leibniz said, Ahmadinejad's speech makes mockery of the U.N. vow, that is, of never again. And then the prime minister from Italy said, Berlusconi accuses Iran of lunacy on Israel. And you know what, friends? I must agree with him. That is lunacy to say that. They want to wipe Israel off the face of the map and that we're near our end, Jack.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, Ahmadinejad is the second Hitler, and he is not a very intelligent man. Why? He says the Holocaust never happened. 6 million Jews did not die. Now, you have to be a loony to believe that the Holocaust never happened. Not only did 6 million Jews die, but 50 million died in totality from the war caused by Hitler. All my relatives in Belgium went to Hitler's factories. They came home on stretchers because he had almost starved all of them to death. Now, just recently, they uncovered 60 years of documents, and it was Adolf Eichmann who at his trial in Israel said, we did murder 6 million. We have all the documents on file. Someday you'll find out. And of course, he was executed. Well, now it's appeared. Are you ready to listen? They've uncovered 50 million pages of history. Right now, it's contained in 16 miles of filing cabinets and storage boxes in six buildings. You say it didn't happen? And it tells where, why, who, when, and what happened to all these precious Jewish people. Never happened. We've got some people like that in religion in America who mock the Jews and who mock the Holocaust. But I'm going to tell you something. This man wants to do what Hitler attempted to do and rid the world of all Jews. And you know that's one of the last signs. That's why we believe we're the generation that's going home. Where is it? Psalm 83:4. Let us cast Israel off from being a nation, that their name be no more in remembrance. And this man is trying to get the entire Arab world, 22 different nations, to march against Israel. But they're not going to succeed. Because the Bible says when it happens, the Lord Jesus returns and puts a stop to those who are destroying the earth and destroying one another, Revelation 11, 18. He sets up his glorious kingdom, and Yahweh the Father says, I'll set my king, Jesus, upon the holy hill of Jerusalem. They're not going to obliterate Jerusalem. They're not going to get rid of the Jews. 1 Chronicles 21:1 says, Satan stood up against the Jews, and any man who hates the Jews is controlled by satanic powers. No doubt about it. Not only that, but in Zechariah 2:10 it says, sing and rejoice, O daughters of Jerusalem, because I, the Messiah, will come and dwell among you. And he's going to reign over Israel and over Jerusalem forever and forever. Luke 1:32, so much so that Jerusalem will be called the city of the great king. It's not the end for Israel. But watch out. for those who hate Israel. Ahmadinejad.